What's up, world? My name is Jonathan Wallace. I'm the owner of Anatomy Apparel, and this is my logo on my shirt. And I want to introduce you to my artwork. My logo is an abstract commercial art representation of the human body, the brain, heart, stomach, hip, waistline, knee, and foot. It has acronyms after each letter representing achievement. Achieving national attention towards overcoming my youth. Anatomy by Jonathan Wallace. I've been working on this logo for a long time. You know, it's my baby. It's gonna be a sport apparel company. We wanted to be big like Nike one day. Great running shoes, great sport apparel. But right now it's eclectic enough to do artwork. So I've been blessed to come to this event and showcase my one piece, but I have more in store, so you know, be looking for me. My name is Jonathan Wallace and my art piece is called Anatomy.
Alright, my name is Melvin Isaac. I'm at the it's a show event with the Fulton Art Fair. It's on Fulton Street between Waverly and Washington. I believe it's the 360. So it's on Fulton Street and it's on a Saturday, which is today. So I'm here with a lot of my other artists, and what I'm doing now is it's sort of like a pop-up exhibit for me, and it's really exciting because the art that I've created to tell you about is my pop-up art. It's a series of art which I'm starting out right now, and the way it goes, I have this is the Mayflower slave ship. And it's taken my ancestors from the continent of Africa and making them out of slaves and put them on a ship and then import them to America. So that's what I'm showing at first. But it's a series of art work that I want to be talking about. The one that's over here is, as you remember, it was the George Floyd. And the George Floyd, even though we was all inside the house and we was all locked up, but because of the George Floyd happened, the incident, a lot of young people, different ethnicity, different nationality, different everything, a lot of young people came out because they said enough is enough. And this paint right here represents this. There's a teacher teaching the students about what happened. And that exploited the Black Lives Movement. They came out because of that, and they marched throughout the whole country, the nation, worldwide. And this upset the electrical system where we got Biden into the office. So this is vital right here. This is very important, this paint right here, where we should never, never forget what happened. Politics, but it's real. The young people, I take my hat off to them, because those the ones that made this whole thing turned around, and they got us Biden as president. So the other painting that I'm doing here that I noticed is right here, it's called, I did this painting right here, and it's called Reaching Out. And it's abstract, it's a hand right here holding another hand, and it's reaching out. Because at that particular time that I was doing this painting, it was being cooped up in the house because of the corona. The corona had devastated the whole world. It devastated me. I thought that was it. I really believed that the world have, it was about to end, because was no vaccine for it. It was no nothing. The only thing that helped us was the nurses. We was inside the house. People was dying because of the corona. So that's why I draw that picture right there, because I was reaching out for help. The last one right here is the boy reading the book. And this is a very, very important picture to especially a lot of young kids, because when you get into a situation where you stop reading and you can't explore your mind, and the reading keeps you focused into a whole different world, and it educates you as well. So this boy right here is reading a lot of different books because he want to be focused, and he want to be somebody. And it tells stories about your reading, who you reading about, different novels. So that's why I did this one right here. He's in the woods somewhere, away from everybody, if you notice it, and he's reading. So that is my pop-up interview, or my story, because every artist have a story. And this is my story. This is my first story for this particular event that I'm doing. And I'm so happy, I'm excited, I'm inspired by all of my other artists that's over here, that sharing their stories, talking about their art, selling their art, and talking to other customers, people that's in the neighborhood, and this neighborhood right here. So thank you again for listening to me, and you will see more of me, of my pop-up. Like I said, this is my first pop-up that I'm doing, that I will be going to different neighborhoods. And in the neighborhood, I'm going to educate all the people about our history, our culture, their journey, our ancestors' journey, of what happened to us, what happened to them, how they was forced from the continent of Africa and made out of slaves, and all the rest of the stuff they went through. And the crazy thing is, when I thought about that, is that we went through so much, but we became president of the United States. Ain't that something? We elevated. So this is our story, this is my story, and this is your story as well. Thank you very much.
This picture is called Eye on the Mountain. It's a mixed media piece. And basically, most of the work that I did mixed media, which includes collage and markers and paint, I usually did it when I was teaching my class, and I started out as a demonstration as to what to do for the subject at the time. And later on, I finished it. This piece I did early on is more astrological. It's done on board. and I sort of like it because it has a nice harmony to it. But that sort of got me started working with astrological forms. This is Praise, Predators and Praise. This also was something I did as a demonstration for my class about using mixed media technique. It's partially called Origin Paint. I sort of like this because really we are all either a predator or a prey in this society. This painting is basically concerned with movement. Sometimes when I see it, I think of flight, but often I also think of the ocean and the waves. But basically the whole idea is the excitement of movement. My name is Robert Sky. You can reach me at 646-721-5746. And my email is bobbybob8334@gmail.com. My Instagram is scott2b_art. Thank you very much.
We shall overcome. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
We remember and we celebrate the conjurers, the crafters, the calculators. We give honor to the rebellion, struggles, plans, and people committed to liberation. We proclaim them the drivers and the dreamers of our freedom. Organizing and broken bones, but never broken spirits. We give honor to the wars rallied up and won in the spiritual realm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she gonna be okay?
The folks
let
that stirred it up in secret places. Time's up. faithfully we embody and activate your dreams. Efforts and sacrifices made way for our emancipation from enslavement. And this is what freedom against. The spirits are stirring again, the winds are changing, we say yes to the possibilities. It is turn up time once again. Time's up for Mustang, for institutional reckoning. Time's up for systemic oppression, seeping into our circulatory, navigating our nervous, we can rock on our muscular and skeletal foundations now. Time's up.